Hi, in this video, I will be talking about one sample Z test. We use this when sigma is known and or when our sample size is large. If our sigma is unknown and our sample size is large, we can use S in place of sigma. In this video, we would also be talking about how to construct a confidence interval for the population mean. We will look into the following example. A restaurant manager claims that the average wait time for customers to get their meals is 6 minutes. A pool of 35 randomly selected customers revealed that the mean wait time is 7.25 minutes. It is known from previous research that the population standard deviation is 2.65 minutes. Test the restaurant manager's claim using a level of significance of 2%. Construct a 98% confidence interval for the population mean. The claim in this question is the average wait time for customers to get their meals is 6 minutes. Therefore, my claim is the null hypothesis. So we write this down as meal equals to six. The corresponding alternative hypothesis will be meal is not equal to six. Then we proceed to find a test statistic using this formula. X bar is the sample mean we got from the question. We have it right there. Meal is the hypothesized mean we are comparing the population mean to. We have six. Sigma is the population standard deviation that was given in the question. N is the sample size that we have as 35. We put all of these values into the formula and we get a test statistic of 2.79. Next, we find the critical value. We can go to Excel and type this into any cell in Excel, this formula into any cell in Excel. The alpha in this question is 0.02. Since it's a two-tailed test, we are going to be dividing alpha by 2 to get 0.01. So when we type this into any cell in Excel, it returns a critical value of negative 2.33. We can also find this value from a standard normal table. From this critical value, we can see that the rejection region is on two tails because it's a two-tailed test. The area on each tail is 0.01. The corresponding critical values on the right tail, positive 2.33, and on the left tail, negative 2.33. If we compare the test statistic to the critical value, we see that it is bigger than the critical value on the right tail. Hence, we can say that the test statistic is greater than the critical value. So it falls in the rejection region. Therefore, we reject the null hypothesis. We can also find the p-value by typing this formula in here into any cell in Excel. Note that in here we have the test statistic. Since this is a right-tailed test, we have to subtract this value we get from 1 and then multiply the result by 2. So our p-value will be 0.005, which is also less than alpha. So we make the same decision and reject the null hypothesis. We can thus conclude that at 2% level of significance, we do not have sufficient evidence to support the claim, since the claim is the null hypothesis. Next, we proceed to find the 98% confidence interval for the population mean. We will use this formula right here. My E is the margin of error, which is computed by taking the critical value multiplied by the population standard deviation divided by the square root of N. So the critical value on one tail we got earlier on to be 2.33. And we have sigma and n from the information that was given. Now we go ahead to compute the margin of error. When we obtain this value, which is 1.04, we are going to be adding and subtracting to our sample mean. So when we do that, we get the upper confidence limit by adding our X bar to the margin of error. And then the lower confidence limit, we subtract our X bar minus the margin of error. Once we get the upper confidence limit and the lower confidence limit, we can write down the confidence interval in this way. We can notice that there is no zero in this confidence interval. So as a result of that, we will be rejecting the null hypothesis, which supports the decision we made earlier on. We can thus interpret our confidence interval by saying we are 98% confident that the population mean wait time is between 6.21 minutes and 7.25 minutes. Thank you for watching this video.